Hello everyone, this is Lata Akula. In this video we are going to study about the third part of the flowering plant, that is the leaf. The leaves are laterally arranged structures. Where they are arranged? They are laterally arranged structures, and mostly these leaves are flattened structures only. In some they may be fleshy and they may be modified into different structures, but mostly majority of the plants, they contain flattened structures only. And where they are born? They are born on the stem. Where they are born? They are born on the stem region only. And they develop at the node. On the stem also, where they were developed from the node, the leaves were developing, and they bear bud. See here, we have already studied about types of bud, axillary bud, right? Here what will happen? They bear buds in its axis. Between the leaf and upper part of the stem, there is an axil is present. In that axil region, the axillary bud will be developed, which will later develop into a stem, into a branch. And then, so these leaves, they originate from the shoot apical meristem. Where they were developed from? They developed from shoot apical meristem. These leaves are arranged in acropetal order. Acropetal order means the new leaves are present at the apex region and the older leaves are arranged at the basal region. So that type of arrangement is called as acropetal order. And this is the important vegetative organs in the plants. Actually, the plant parts are divided into two parts, vegetative parts and reproductive parts. The flower is called as reproductive organ, and the remaining parts like root, leaf, stem, all these are called as vegetative parts. So in those vegetative parts, this is the most important vegetative organ in which photosynthesis occurs. What will happen here? Photosynthesis occurs by using the sunlight, and by means of which this process only the leaves are able to prepare the food material. Hence it is the important vegetative organs in the plants. And if you see the structure of the leaf, the leaf consists of three parts. They are leaf base, petiole and leaf lamina. What are the three parts? Leaf base, petiole and the leaf lamina are the three parts present in the leaf. The first one, leaf base. So the lowermost part of the leaf is called as leaf base. So here, the lowermost part of the leaf, by means of which it is attached to the stem at the node region, that is called as leaf base. And at the leaf base, there are two green colored leaf like structures are present, which are called as stipules. What are stipules? Are the leaf base region. Laterally, there are two small leaf like structures are present, which are called as stipules. And in monocots, the leaf base expands. This leaf base expands and form a sheath around the stem. That sheath will cover the stem either partially or totally. And in the leguminous plants, not all, in some leguminous plants, the leaf base is swollen like this. The leaf base will be swollen structure, that is called as pulvinus. So this is swollen leaf base is called as pulvinus, which is seen in the leguminous plants. And another part of the leaf is the petiole. Here the stalk of the leaf is called as petiole. See this, this is the stalk, right? The stalk of the leaf is called as petiole, and it holds the leaf above the level of the stem to allow proper sunlight to fall on the leaves. The function of this petiole is, it holds the leaf above the level of the stem. For example, if this is the stem, it holds the leaf above the stem to allow the proper sunlight to fall on the leaf, by means of which it will carries out photosynthesis. And this petiole allows the fluttering. For example, this is a leaf, this is the petiole. It helps in the fluttering of the leaves in the wind, through which the leaf will get proper aeration and it will give some cooling effect to the leaves also. And another one is the last part of the leaf is the lamina or blade. This lamina is nothing but a green expanded part. this larger brain, expanded part of this leaf is called as a leaf lamina or leaf blade. Here, this lamina or leaf blade, it consists of the margin is called as leaf margin. The central, the prominent, there is a central prominent vein is present, which is called as midrib. What it is? Midrib. And this midrib will be branched into several veins and veinlets. Here, these veins and veinlets, they provide rigidity and strength to the total part of the leaf. And these veins not only gives the rigidity and strength to the leaf, they acts as the channels for the transport of water, minerals and food materials to the various parts of the plants, from the stem, from the roots to the leaf, and from the leaves to the different parts of the plant, like food material will be transported. So here these veins and veinlets, they will act as the channels for the transport of water, minerals and food material will be transported by these veins only. This is about the structure of the leaf. So once again, we'll study where the leaves are present. They are laterally arranged and mostly these are flattened structure. They are borne on the stem. On the stem, they are present on the node region. On the node region only, node region, the leaf is attached. There is a bud is present in that axil region, which is called as axillary bud, and it originates from the shoot apical meristem, and the leaves are arranged acropetal order, an important vegetative organ for the photosynthesis. And the parts of the leaf, if you see, there are three parts: leaf base, petiole and lamina. The leaf base is the lowermost part of the leaf, is called as leaf base, which is attached to the stem by means of the node. And there are two green color small leaf like structures are present, which are called as stipules. In the monocots, this leaf base expands and forms a sheet like structure covering the stem, either totally or partially. And the in leguminous plants, this leaf base is swollen, and the swollen part of the leaf base is called as pulvinus. And the second part is the petiole. The petiole is nothing but the stalk of the leaf. Here, this petiole will act as it was connecting the leaf lamina to the leaf base, and it will helps in the fluttering of the leaf, and also for holds the leaf base above the level of the stem, by means of which that provide proper sunlight. And another one, last part of the leaf is the lamina or blade, that is the green colored, the expanded part of the leaf is called as a lamina or blade. It consists of margin, which is called as leaf margin. The central, there is a prominent midrib is present, and it is branched into the separate veins and veinlets. So these veins and veinlets, they give strength and rigidity to the leaf. They not only provide strength and rigidity, they also act as channels for the transport of water and minerals and food materials. The next topic is venation.